Having specific knowledge is key to starting a business, but where to start? What can we learn from entrepreneurs? Wim van Hoeven from Tide Microfluidics explains his journey.
I started thinking about this business idea actually already during my PhD. During my PhD, the technology was developed to create an ultrasound contrast agent, or actually it was much more broader. It was really the fundamental questions: how can we make particles? During that time, I was already in contact with the pharmaceutical industry, people working in the food industry, and they were very much interested in better understanding how to create small particles. So the initial ideas were started during my PhD.
However, research experience is not always enough, and customer insights are important to identify the opportunity.
But maybe also a very important aspect was after my PhD. I worked then as a consultant at a pharmaceutical company in Switzerland. And during that time, I could really identify a clear market need for this technology. And there I saw that this technology can be used to produce ultrasound contrast agents in a much better way.
Personal experience is also key to trigger the idea. Then the idea is not the direct result of technology expertise, but rather driven by a problem the entrepreneur recognizes, like Henk Arnst from Snowcom explains.
In the winter of 2010-2011, there was like a huge snowfall in the Netherlands, and I got stuck into a Dutch train due to a few centimeters of snow. So I had plenty of time to think about the challenges of snow. And I saw a little video on YouTube about how they tackle the challenges on a runway of airports. I saw all these trucks next to each other, plowing the snow to one side. And I thought, would it be better if we make just one machine driving over a runway and then get rid of the snow straight away? But then I started calculating, and I found out that you need to compress the snow, because otherwise the whole concept wouldn't work. So that moment when I got stuck into the train made me think, well, that didn't stop.
And of course, market development plays a crucial role, which is explained by Konstantinos Patanios from Enchroma.
The idea was developed by a perceived need in the market. The food industry right now is changing all the artificial colors used in their food products, and they want to replace them with natural colors. To do this, they have to use, of course, plants. And plants compete with agricultural land and therefore with food. And they're very low in quality. Therefore, we want to provide a new type of colorants, and we want to use microorganisms to do that.
The idea is just the beginning. Starting a company also requires commitment to a set of tasks, which is significantly different from performing research or scientific work. What was the experience then for an engineer to become an entrepreneur?
It did not really felt as a transition for me. It was more a natural progression. However, I think during the time I also met people that were a bit surprised that a scientist can actually also be an entrepreneur.
Being a student gives you benefits to start a company. You will travel a road that is unknown, but you have the time to spend and look into the details and take the wrong turn. According to Henk from Snowcom, you can run some risks because you have little to lose.
It's a very good thing if you are a student and entrepreneur at the same time, because if you're a student, you are, first of all, you're almost a blank page. So if you experience a lot of challenges, like problems from the market, you start thinking about solutions for this challenge without much prior knowledge about what is possible, how do corporates work, how do large institutions work. You just don't know. The only thing you know is that you have a problem, and you need to find a solution, and you have the time to think about the solution, so you can think outside the box. And there's nothing to lose.
Yet you are trained as an engineer, and the entrepreneurial task is different from that of an engineer.
I have knowledge in science, so basically I have a bachelor in biology. Now I'm taking my master's in plant biotechnology here at Wageningen University and Research. And this is the knowledge I have, but I didn't have any knowledge in entrepreneurship. Therefore, when I joined my master's here at the university, I took several courses in entrepreneurship, and I obtained skills, let's say, in entrepreneurship on how to build a business model canvas, how to approach the customer.
Technology is exactly that asset that makes your company unique and may deliver value to others.
To make the transition, it was for me very important to have a firm base, and the technology, I knew we had a very reliable technology, reliable and robust, and that we could make these ultrasound contrast agents. And second, the knowledge that this could really be used to solve an important issue in the field. So there was a clear market need, and this knowledge, I think, was the basis of our company.
In terms of science, I created a thesis program to develop the technology for my company. So I approached a professor here at the university, and we created this technology, let's say this minor thesis, to develop the technology. In terms of entrepreneurship, Start Life is a huge impactor into this, and they provide the tools to, let's say, develop a business model canvas or approach your clients and do a market analysis, etc.